हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू योर चैनल फिनोमेन। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द वन बेस्ट स्मॉल कैप कंपनी एंड दैट इज़ अ लीडर इन इट्स सेक्टर एंड दिस स्टॉक इज अवेलेबल एट वेरी अट्रैक्टिव प्राइजेस। सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द स्टॉक। द नेम ऑफ द स्टॉक और कंपनी इज महानगर गैस लिमिटेड, दैट इज MGL। इट इज एक्चुअली एन इंडियन नेचुरल गैस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनी विच वॉज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन 1995। MGL इज एक्चुअली एन एंटरप्राइज ऑफ गेल इंडिया लिमिटेड एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, दैट इज गेल इंडिया लिमिटेड एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र हैविंग अ गुड स्टेक इन द MGL। सो इट इज बेसिकली अ गवर्नमेंट कंपनी। नाउ कमिंग टू द ऑपरेशन पार्ट, द महानगर गैस इज प्रेजेंटली सप्लाइंग द CNG, दैट इज कंप्रेस्ड नेचुरल गैस, अराउंड 0.77 million टू वेरियस व्हीकल्स लाइक फोर व्हीलर एक्सेट्रा, एंड PNG, दैट इज पाइप नेचुरल गैस, दैट इज कुकिंग गैस विच वी आर यूजिंग इन अवर हाउस होल्ड पर्पज, दैट इज PNG सप्लाइंग अराउंड 1.53 million टू डोमेस्टिक हाउस होल्ड, दैट इज कुकिंग गैस विच वी आर यूजिंग इन अवर होम इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द MGL। डिसाइड दिस इज ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडिंग द 3,342 buses, that is ST, TMT, MSRTC, NMMT buses providing the CNG, and also providing the more than 6,580 tempos, truck, private buses that they are using the CNG, which are supplied by the MGL through its wide distribution network. Now we will do a first basic parameters of the company. So as you can see, the market cap of the company is just 8,381 crore, that is below 10,000 crore, so it is a small cap company. So invest as per your risk appetite. The current market price of the stock is around 850 rupees. Stock is very attractive. Stock PE, that is stock is trading around 10 P, so stock is very undervalued stock and very good stock from the government sector. The book value of the company is also very attractive, that is almost 350 rupees. ROE and ROE is very fantastic. ROE is 27% around, and ROE return on equity is also very fantastic, almost 20%. The 52-week high of this company is around 1300 rupees, and 52-week low is 834. So stock, you can say, that is trading near to the 52-week low. Dividend yield is also fantastic, that is company is distributing the dividend to its shareholder around 3%. So if you are a shareholder of MGL, you will be earning 3% return on your shares every year. The face value of the company is 10 rupees. Now we will do a technical analysis of the stock. So as you can see, this is a candlestick chart. So as we can see, three lines, black color lines are there. The first black color line is called as upper Bollinger band. Second black color line is called as middle Bollinger band, and third line is called as lower Bollinger band. If the stock is trading at the upper Bollinger band, it is called that stock is at bullish phase. If it is at a middle Bollinger band, then stock is at reasonable price, and if it is trading below the lower Bollinger band, then it is called as stock in a bearish mode. So as you can see, the candles are becoming near to the lower Bollinger band, so you can say that stock is trading in a bearish mode. And red color line, that 1095 is the price of the stock, and green color line, that is almost 945 rupees. So red color line is a 200 days moving averages, and green color line is 50 days moving averages. If the stock is trading below the 200 days moving averages, it is called as share is a long term bearish, and if it is trading below 50 days moving average, then stock is called as short term bearish. So as you can see, that candles are becoming below the 200 days moving and 50 days, so completely stock is in a bearish mode from the long term perspective as well as in short term perspective. So candlestick chart simply says stock is in a bearish mode, so you can accumulate the stock for a longer period in a small quantity. Now we will do a MACD chart analysis. So black color line is called as MACD line, and red color line is called as bearish crossover. If the bearish crossover, that is red line, is above the black color line, it is called as stock in bearish mode, and if the vice versa, black color line is above the bearish crossover, then it is called a stock in a bullish phase. So as you can see that from few days, this bearish crossover was up than the bullish crossover. Now it has crossed, almost crossed to the black color line, is crossing the red color line. So now it is showing that reversal of the stock, that is, stock is moving towards the upper side. So MACD's chart is simply showing that the stock is in a upper side, and above is the histogram. If the histogram is becoming green, then it is called as bullishness in the stock, and if the histogram is becoming red, then it is called as bearishness in the stock. Now we'll do a RSI analysis. Normally it is called by the expert that RSI is trading between 40 to 80. It is called as stock is trading at a reasonable price. If stock goes, if the RSI goes above 80, then it is called as stock is overbought zone. You have to sell the stock because stock is now become very hot and heated. Now if the RSI is below 20, it is called as stock is in oversold zone. You can start to accumulate the stock at the very small quantity. So now you can say that MGL RSI shows that it is trading at 32 RSI. So stock is near to the 20 RSI. So stock is in a bearish mode and it is become a oversold zone. So you can start accumulating the stock if your duration or horizon for a longer period. Now we will do a fundamental analysis of the stock. This is the fundamental analysis for the 5 years. As you can see, the company has not made a extreme handsome sales, but it has maintained its sales. It was around 2034 crore in 2017 and it is almost consistent or stagnant around 2153. Operating margin, that is main business profit, is almost increased to 50%. That is, it was around 644 crore in 2017, now it has jumped to 934 crore in March 2021, almost increase of 50%. Operating profit margins, that is margins of the company, has also increased, that is from 32% in 2017, now it has become to 43% in March 2021. Other income has also increased almost double, 53 crore to 81 crore. And interest part, that is interest on the borrowings, that the, as you can see, the company has almost debt free company. The main part of this company I liked it is company is almost debt free company. It was paying around 1 crore in 18 and 19. Company was not paying any interest because company has no borrowings, and in recently company has taken loan, so it has paying just 7 crore of interest. Profit before tax is also increased by 50% from 600 crore to 834 crore in 2021. Net profit after tax has also increased by 50%, that is 393 crore in 2017, now it has become to 620 rupees. So as you can see, the company has not made any drastic move in sales, but the profit and operating margins have increased by 50%. So company is improving its profit margin and net profit. Now EPS is also very fantastic, almost from 40 it was in 2017, now it has become to 60. It has also increased by almost 50%. Dividend payout is very fantastic, that is company is almost paying 50% of its profit to the shareholder, that is 48% in 2017, almost 37% in 2020. That is, company is earning net profit and from that 50% is distributing as dividend to its shareholder and 50% is keeping as retained earning, that is reserves and surplus. We'll do a balance sheet analysis. The share capital is very attractive, only 99 crore, the very less equity. If the equity of the company is very less, the chances of going for the stock is very high because profit is distributed to very less number of shareholder. Reserves is very, as you can see, reserves company has increased almost double. It was around 1741 crore in 2017 and it has gone to doubled 3402. Even after distributing 50% of its profit to the shareholder, company managed to double its reserve in the last duration of 5 years. So this is the best part of the company which I liked. And third part is borrowing, the almost negligible borrowing. It was 3 crore in 18, it was almost nothing, 19 0. Company has lately taken the borrowing and that is also negligible. Fixed asset has also increased from 1300 to almost, you can say, near to the double, that is 2223. And finally we will do a shareholding pattern analysis. So from June 20 to September 21, promoter have stagnant holding of 32%, FIIs having a stagnant holding of almost 29 to 30% from last 1 year, that is June to 21. DIIs also have maintained stagnant, that is from 18% 19 to 18% ranging. Government, that is government of Maharashtra, is also holding 10% holding, and public is also having a less holding. That is, you can say that more of the stock is with the big institutions. This public having only 9%, and now it is almost 10% holding. If you feel that video is useful to you, then please do like our video and please subscribe to our channel Finoment if you have still not subscribed it, and press the bell button so that you will get the notifications for the next videos. And also please comment it in the comment box on which topic you want to watch the next videos.